Thank you for joining us today as we talk about getting started with Azure Sentinel Notebooks. My name's Pete Bryan, and I work for the Microsoft Threat Intelligence Center. One of the really powerful features of Azure Sentinel is its integration with notebooks. These allow you to conduct advanced threat hunting and incident response activities right there in the browser within Azure Sentinel. What we'll do today is step through our Getting Started notebook to help get you up to speed with what notebooks are, how they work, and how to configure them. From there, you can go on and try some of the more advanced notebooks within Azure Sentinel. The first thing we're going to do is navigate to the Notebooks tab in the Azure Sentinel portal, and here we can see a list of our available notebooks. What you can see here is the name of the available notebooks, followed by a short description and some screenshots on the right-hand pane. You can browse through these notebooks to find the one most useful, but today we're going to run the Getting Started notebook. By clicking Launch, I'm taken through to a pane where I'm asked to select my Azure ML workspace. This is the workspace where we'll be running the notebook. If you don't already have one, you can create a workspace from here, but what I'm going to do is select my workspace and click Launch. This takes me straight to the Azure ML workspace and loads the notebook that I selected. You can see here on the left, a navigation pane with all my files, and on the right, my main notebook pane, where I can see and interact with the notebook I selected. The first thing to do is make sure I select Compute. You may not have Compute, and if you don't, you'll be presented with a banner and prompted. Otherwise, you can select the Compute that you need, and then select the kernel you want to execute with. Again, you'll be prompted for this if this is not set, but what you're looking for is the kernel idle message in the blue bar at the top. Once you have that, you know that your compute and your kernel are ready to go. We can now hide the navigation bar so we get some more screen real estate for the notebook itself. Now, notebooks are an interactive code-based environment that you run straight in the browser. You have cells where you enter data. This data could be text data, which is displayed as markdown, as the cells you're looking at now are, or they can be interactive code cells that we can run and see the output of, which we'll go on to in a second. Jupyter Notebooks are very powerful, and their integration with Azure and Azure Sentinel is a great benefit for defenders. Now, to run our code cell, we simply select the cell, which we have here with some Python code in, and we click the Run Cell button. We then see the output of that code immediately below it. Any variables defined in that code can be referenced by subsequent cells, as we're doing here. That's a very basic example of running code. What we're going to do now is install a number of libraries and packages that we're going to use later in the notebook. This setup cell is one that appears at the top of many of the Azure Sentinel notebooks and handles that process for you. Again, we simply need to select the cell and click the Run button. From here, we can see we're prompted to confirm we want to install an Azure ML environment, which we're doing. And then we'll see a further message telling us that the notebook setup is complete. The next stage is to set our configuration data. This is data we will use to connect to our various data sources. This is stored in the MysticPy config file. Unless you've run this notebook before or configured the file separately, this might not be present for you. The following steps will tell you whether you have a populated file and step you through creating one. Running this first cell will display the contents of any file that is present. Here we can see we have a blank file because the values are displayed as null. If you run this cell and see populated values, you can skip the next couple of cells. However, as we don't have them populated here, we're going to run the next cells to collect that data and write it to our config file. This cell will prompt us to enter the key details we need. This involves our log analytics or Azure Sentinel workspace details and various external services we'll use. read the markdown in this document to learn where and how to get this information. Once you have it, you can simply enter it into the boxes. Once entered, the next cell will write that data into our configuration file for us, and then reload that file to make sure we have the latest configuration. You may see a warning about certain configuration elements being missing. This is okay, we're not using every element of the configuration in this file. What you're looking for is the no errors found message. Get some data from our Azure Sentinel workspace. For this, we're using the query provider feature of Mystic Pi. And we're going to instantiate a query provider, and then we're going to connect to it. Running this cell provides us with a code and a link to go verify our device. We simply copy that code, follow the link, enter it, and authenticate. When completed, we should see this pop-up schema button, which will show us the schema of the workspace we're connected to. Now we've done that, we can start to look at what's available to us. The first thing we're going to do is look at the tables in our workspace and the schema for one of those tables. Here you see some table names and then the schema for our sign-in logs table. The easiest way to collect data is by running the built-in queries that Mystic Pi provides. We can see those by running list queries, which provides us a list of the names of the queries, And then we can call a specific query name to get more details on it, such as what parameters we can provide it and what it does. Next, we're going to set some time parameters and call one of these queries. In this case, we don't have any data in our workspace in this time frame, but that's okay. This is showing how you run the query. Now what we're going to do is run another query to get some data to use for future cells. In this case, we don't have any live data, so instead we've loaded a sample data set for us to use further in the document. The table that is displayed as the output for our data is something called a pandas data frame. This is a common output type for our queries using notebooks. Pandas are a very flexible and powerful data management tool. And here we'll show you how to display and manage them. To display, we simply call the name of our pandas data frame and it will display out, or we can call the display feature to display that same data frame. And again, here we see the data frame displayed as a table below. We can also display different elements of that data frame. For example, we can display the first two rows of it rather than the whole thing. Or we can display a specific row in the table. Here you'll see that row has been converted into its own separate table. We can also view the columns in the table as a list of strings. And we can choose to display a subset of the columns. So in this case, time generated and tenant ID. We can also filter on the columns. In this case, we're looking for a particular value in one of our columns. And here we see the rows returned where that column value matches what we input. We can also get it to filter on multiple values. Here we're seeing results for the two values we're filtering on. And we can also extend the data frame by adding extra columns. In this case, just adding some extra data to every new column. Once we've collected data, we're going to want to enrich it for our security investigator. Here we're taking a IP address field from our data and looking that value up in the Virus Total Threat Intelligence feed. Here we query that API using the configuration file data we set earlier, and we get a result again in a pandas data frame, showing us the value we looked up and what the response was. We can also do this for multiple values at once and look up every IP address in that table. Here, we're doing just that, again, using VirusTotal. And again, we get a pandas data frame with our results. Here, we've just filtered down to a subset of columns to display. We can also analyze the data in different ways. Here, we're using the base64 decode function of MysticPy to take a base64 encoded command string and see the raw string that's underneath it. Here we can see a user was trying to download a file off an external website. We can also extract indicators of compromise from external files. Again, here we're downloading a file from US cert and extracting all the DNS and domain name type indicators of compromise from it. Here we can see the top 5 indicators from that report listed out as strings. Another powerful feature of notebooks is the ability to visualize data. Here, using pandas and matplotlib, we can create some basic graphs. A bar chart showing the number of times we've seen each of those IP addresses, and here a pie chart on the same thing. These are very basic visualizations using some of the other libraries we list here and the inbuilt visualizations in MysticPy. You can create much more complex visualizations for yourself. I strongly recommend that you work through this Getting Started notebook, reading all the details we've put in it, and also following some of the links that we provide in the appendix and the Learn More section. This will give you a greater understanding of both notebooks and the Python code we use. Once you've got this and you've successfully run the Getting Started notebook, you can move on and run some of the other notebooks that we provide via Azure Sentinel that go deeper into security investigation, threat hunting, and incident response scenarios. Thank you for joining us. I hope you found this video useful. For more details on Azure Sentinel, notebooks, and how to get the most from the product, check out our resources at the Tech Community blog and at docs.microsoft.com.